So now that we've built it ourselves, I'm going to show you the easy way to do it, which is to use the built-in Python type called a dictionary. And what a dictionary is really an implementation of a hash table. It's built into Python, so it's much easier to use than defining our own hash table. So far, we've seen two complex types in Python. We've seen the string type, and we've seen the list type. Now we're going to introduce the dictionary type. So there are many things that are common between these three. There are other things that are different. So to create a string, we could have a sequence of characters inside quotes. To create a list, we use the square bracket, and we could have a sequence of elements inside the square bracket. And the elements could be any type, unlike a string where they had to be characters. So our string was a sequence of characters. Our list was a list of any kind of value, so a list of elements of any value. The dictionary type, we're going to create using the curly bracket. And the entries inside a dictionary are key value pairs. So here I've created a dictionary with two elements. And each element, the key is a string. Here's the string hydrogen. And the value associated with that element is a number. The keys in a dictionary can be any immutable value. So they don't need to be strings. They could be numbers. They could be other things. The values can be any value. So what a dictionary is a set of key value pairs, and the property that a dictionary will give us is like the hash table, that we can look up a key and get the value associated with that key. So one important property of all types is whether they're immutable or mutable. We saw that the string was immutable. That means once we create a string, we can't modify that string. It has the same value it always has. A list was mutable. We could change the values of elements in the list. After we create the list, we could append to the list, adding new elements to it. A dictionary is also mutable. So after we create a dictionary, we could add new key value pairs to it. We could change the value of values associated with keys. We saw with strings, if s is a string, then we can do s index I. That will give us the ith letter in string. With lists, we can do something very similar. If p is a list, we can do p index I to get the ith element of the list. With dictionaries, it's a little bit different. The syntax is the same. We can do d index k. With both strings and lists, these were numbers. Here, the k is whatever the key value is. So this is a key in the dictionary. What d index k will give us the value associated with that key in the dictionary. We'll see some examples soon. We can also use our indexing and assignments. We saw with a list, we could do this. That would replace the value of the ith element of p with whatever we have here. With a string, we can't do that. That produces an error. And the reason we can't do it is because strings are immutable. So there's no way to modify characters in a string. With a dictionary, we can. And what the meaning of this is very similar to the meaning of update in our hash table. So that's equivalent to update the value associated with k to be v.